Hey friends, and welcome back to the channel. I hope you like my new little neon sign, which I got from AliExpress. You know me, I'm pretty cheap, so I found a really good neon sign on AliExpress, and it was only like 10 bucks, so yeah, fun fact. So in this video, I'm gonna give you why automated investing works for me and how I currently invest each month so I can invest automatically. So the other day, this company reached out to me and they are a Bitcoin mining company. And they told me that if I invest $1,000 per month, they will give me a return of $4,000. So I'm investing all of my money into this Bitcoin mining company. I'm just kidding, guys. I don't actually invest in any Bitcoin mining companies or any scams like that. But in this video, I wanted to give you an insight into how I currently automate my investing. So this is how I currently invest each month. I use an investing strategy called dollar cost averaging. Dollar cost averaging is essentially making the exact same amount of investments at the same time each month. And the strategy with dollar cost averaging is you will get the average returns of the market. So you buy when the market is high and you buy when the market is low. And the whole principle of dollar cost averaging is that time in the market beats timing the market. Because sometimes when you do buy when the price is really low and the market does drop, if you do get lucky every couple of years, since you're not investing your money regularly, you're not taking advantage of that compound interest. And that's why time in the market, to me, beats timing the market. I also like that I don't have to think about it and I can pretty much just execute on my strategy every single month because I've already done my research and I have my strategy set. And it also saves me time and money. It saves me time because I don't have to keep looking at the charts to see whether it's a good time to buy in. I'm pretty much just executing on my strategy because I've already done the research up front in the different ETFs and individual stocks that I would like to buy into. And it also doesn't cost me very much money as well. Here in Australia, we do unfortunately have brokerage fees. So when I am investing a lump sum every single month, I'm not spending too much money on my brokerage fees. Rather than if I was day trading, I would be spending quite a lot in brokerage fees. So let's jump into what I do when I get paid. So when I get paid, and I get paid monthly, I transfer 60% of my income into my offset account. The offset account is my savings account, which is attached to my mortgage. So all of the money in my offset accounts offsets the interest that I pay on my mortgage. I calculate my monthly expenses using the WeMoney and the Finder app, and I've got some links to those apps in the description below. If you sign up to any of these links, we both get some free money, so it's a win-win situation. So since I've been tracking my expenses for quite a long time, I already kind of know how much money I spend each month. So I always just transfer 60% of my income into my offset account because I know that the 40% of my income will be used for my expenses. I do use a credit card for pretty much all of my transactions. So I do use the 40%, which is in my savings account, to pay off my credit card. So I can pay it off in full, not incur any interest, and also redeem it for free points and free travel. I also did want to note that even as I started to earn more income, I tried to keep my expenses pretty much exactly the same. So then as I was increasing my income, I could also increase my investments as well and try to keep my lifestyle pretty much the same or as minimal as possible. So then I can save and invest more money. And I did also want to mention that I do also have an emergency fund, which is also in my offset account. And an emergency fund is from 3 to 6 months of your living expenses saved in cash in a liquid bank account. So you can use this money at any time, just in case you encounter any emergencies. So then you don't have to dip into your investments, which could be a bad thing, especially if you are selling at a low point in the market. We don't want to be touching our investments for a really long time because we don't want to lose money. So the next thing I do is I invest all of the money that I have in my offset account into Dogecoin and Bitcoin because they are going to the moon, people. I'm just joking, I don't actually do that, but make sure you do give this video a like if you are enjoying this video so far. So the money which is in my offset account includes my emergency fund and also the money that I use for my investing. So I pretty much transfer money from my offset account into my brokerage account, but I do leave my 3 to 6 month emergency fund in my offset account. So I do have an ideal portfolio which I am trying to copy, so then I can ensure that I'm not making any emotional decisions with my investing. And it is all quite strategic. So then I don't go 100% in on Dogecoin. I used to fully use StockSpot for all of my investments. Since it is pretty much an automated portfolio, all you really need to do is transfer your money into StockSpot and it automatically diversifies your investments for you. I currently do have a bit of money in my StockSpot portfolio, but I do have an ideal portfolio which I am trying to copy with my investments. And by the way, if you would like to check out StockSpot for yourself, I've also got a link in my description below, and using this link, you'll get your first $5,000 managed completely for free. So I currently use CMC Markets as my brokerage account. They do have $11 brokerage fees on Australian shares, but they have free brokerage for US shares, Canadian shares, Japanese and UK shares, which is really cool because there aren't very many Australian brokerage sites that actually have free brokerage, apart from Stake, which only has access to the US stock market. So I've added some ETFs into my CMC Markets portfolio and also to my watch list based on the ideal portfolio that I'm trying to follow. And these are all ETFs which are aligned with my investing strategy. So my whole stock market portfolio consists of 75% in ETFs, 20% in individual stocks, and 5% in cryptocurrencies. And every single month, I invest that 60% of my income in an ETF of my choice. So each month I check how my portfolio is doing on ShareSite. And ShareSite has this really cool tool where it can show you your current portfolio allocation and see how diversified it is. And I basically use this diversification tool to see if I do need to rebalance my portfolio or add any particular ETFs or stocks to my portfolio so that it can mirror the ideal portfolio that I'm trying to build. And it also helps me make more informed decisions about which investment I would like to make that month. So I top up my portfolio based on the current balance that I have in my portfolio, or if there are any ETFs or individual stocks that are looking a little bit down. If they have gone through a bit of a dip lately, then I usually buy the dip and actually invest a little bit more money into those ETFs or individual stocks, especially if I do believe in them long term. And if you would like to check out ShareSite for yourself, I highly recommend it. I love this tool so much. I actually check it daily. I think there's something wrong with me, but I really, really love seeing my money making more money. And I don't know, it just makes it really exciting for me. Even though my portfolio doesn't go through crazy swings, I just like seeing all of my money making more money in my ShareSite. So if you would also like to check out your portfolio and you're a little bit like me and you have money in a bunch of different places, this can really help you track your full portfolio and see how it's performing over time and see what your actual returns are, including what your dividends are, because sometimes I find that with brokerage sites, you don't really get to see your dividends accurately, but with ShareSite, you can easily see your dividends and see that as a percentage of your portfolio. So for example, if you get a 4% dividend, that is also counted in your net investment return. And if you sign up using my link, you get an extra month of the Pro plan completely for free. So that is how I currently automate my investing, so I can pretty much dollar cost average into my investments and not have to think about it too much. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it useful. If you did like this video, make sure you give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel for more videos about investing and personal finance. I'll see you in the next video. Bye! And if you'd like to see some more videos, I've got some links to some videos here. So make sure you click the links and click through to another video.